gather today for the 18th Annual Law Enforcement Appreciation Day Ceremony sponsored by the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, the Department of Aging and Human Services, and the Triad Salt Council. We'd like to thank Dr. Mel Powell and the Southern Maryland Higher Education Center for hosting this event. The ceremony honors law enforcement officers who have made the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty over the years, as well as the law enforcement agencies and their officers for the outstanding service they provide to our community every day.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, my fellow law enforcement and corrections colleagues, it is a good day. I want to thank the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, Salt Triad, St. Mary's Department of Aging, and our local businesses and organizations sponsoring and supporting this annual Law Enforcement Day. I want to also extend our thanks to this venue, which has been a great venue, our sponsor, Southern Maryland Higher Education Center. On Peace Officers Memorial Day and during Police Week, we recognize and honor the serving and sacrifice of the men and women whose devotion to duty brings honor to our system of justice and makes America a better place. In every American community, committed law enforcement and correctional officers watch over our communities and work to make our nation a safer, more peaceful place. In 2017, our ranks experienced a loss of 135 peace officers. And to date, in 2018, our nation has lost 50 peace officers, 26 by gunfire. These fallen officers live on in our national memory as Americans whose courage and commitment have shown the true meaning of heroism. We gather here at this annual ceremony to acknowledge the officers whose names appear on the walls of the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial and to express our gratitude and honor our peace officers for their service, their commitment, and their sacrifice. I thank all those that serve for your commitment and courage, and I thank your families for their sacrifices as well. I want to congratulate each recipient for your exemplary service and in keeping in the highest traditions and standards of your agencies and our profession. This has been an unprecedented year, to say the least, and I've never done this before, but in addition to our awardees today, I would like all our law enforcement officers, our peace officers here today, please stand and be recognized. All of you, please. May the last name on the wall remain the last name on the wall. May God bless you and keep you safe. Thank you.
Bring a little humor into this first. I was just talking to the sheriff before this, and I said, you are going to talk longer to me than me, right? And he goes, you're the preacher. So anyway, with that, greetings in the name of the Lord. And my name is Pastor Chris McCombs. I am the senior pastor at Lexington Park Baptist Church. My background is in military first and then the ministry. And I come from a law enforcement family as my married into one with my wife. And I love to see all the men and women that wear the uniform. My brother-in-law is a retired state trooper from Maryland. And my nephew just recently graduated from the academy, Curtis Manuel, carrying on the legacy of law enforcement in our family. So I salute you. I'm proud to stand here with you. And it's an honor to speak to all of the men and women here today in the memory of those that have gone before us. Seems like almost every day, in fact, today, I said, Alexa, what's going on the news today? And I don't know if you heard, but another officer was shot just yesterday. So it seems like almost every day we hear of a tragedy. We hear of a law enforcement agent that has been shot either in the line of duty or even in things like just sitting in their patrol car or having a dinner with a fellow officer on their break. But protecting and defending our citizens has become a dangerous hazard even beyond the norm of what you do each and every day. So I would ask us to remember today all the families that have lost loved ones in the line of duty. I salute you. I cannot imagine the sacrifice you have made. We also want to remember those that have put their line on the line of duty and have given their life. Jesus said, "Greater love hath no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends." Obviously, we hope the last name on the wall is the last name. But I am grateful for those who do give of themselves and those that have given their lives even for the good of society. I would pray and ask us right now to have a moment of silence in remembrance of them. Father God, you tell us to be still and to know that you are God and that you will be exalted above us. So in this moment of stillness, may we know you're here. May we know that you care for each of the fallen men and women that have given their lives and as they have served our communities. Father, we are grateful for their sacrifice. We hope no other sacrifices ever have to be made. So we salute them, we remember them, we grieve with them and their families, and we lift them up to you right now in the powerful name of Christ. Amen. In Baptist tradition, we have it in memorial services, we remember the one that has gone before us. So I hope that's the remembrance part that we've just done. But I know I'd be remiss if I don't minister to the living. We are the ones that carry on the legacy. We are the ones that carry on what they have stood for. And that we carry on the law enforcement aspects in our community. Perhaps many of you are familiar with the six shooter. I know you all carry those still today, right, Sheriff?
No.
Thing of the past. I know that. I was just making sure he's paying attention, right? Who remembers the Lone Ranger?
Oh, yeah.
Wow. What a law enforcement agent, right? I mean, he had a six shooter with silver bullets, right? So I would like to give you six spiritual silver bullets to all of the law enforcement agents in this room, but also to all of us, that you may carry these with you. Just six scriptures that I thought would bless us and carry on the legacy of those that have gone before us. Bullet number one. There's a test, Sheriff, so pay attention. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be blessed by God because they are children of God. May you always carry a bullet of peace with you. You bring peace to our community. I thank you for that. And the Lord says you are blessed because of that. Bullet number two. Depend on your training. Psalm 144, 1 says this. Blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. I am grateful that you are well trained. I am grateful that if I call 911, that you're coming to help me, my family, and those that I love. I am grateful that if you have to carry out your duty, you will, and that your hands have been trained for war and your fingers for battle. I've been privileged to pray over several people when they've taken their oath of office. Recently, with Trooper Manuel, my nephew, and I asked him, and you troopers will appreciate this, I said, "Curtis, can I pray over your gun?" He immediately looked at me with big eyes, and he goes, "As long as you don't take it out of the holster." And I said, "I won't," and I prayed. And I want you to hear the prayer I prayed over everyone. Lord, I pray for this new officer. I pray that they never have to draw this gun. But if they ever do, may they do so to protect themselves, those they serve with, and those who they are sworn to protect. May they always shoot straight, and may they always be protected by you. In Jesus' name, amen. May you be trained. May you know that God steadies your hand. And may you know that your finger is ready whenever needed. Bullet three, justice. When justice is done, it is a joy to the righteous, but terror for evildoers. May you always carry the bullet of justice. And when you carry that bullet of justice, may you know to those of us that are trying to be good citizens in society, you are a joy. I know you don't always hear that, especially when you give someone a ticket. Amen? All right? But you are a joy to our society when you carry out righteousness. And you are a terror to those who want to do evil in our communities. Bullet four. Now, this is one you don't like. You got to give this bullet back. It's the bullet of vengeance. Vengeance is mine, declares the Lord. Never forget who you are and who you are not. God is God alone. Bullet five. Fear not. Have I not commanded you be strong and courageous? Do not fear. Do not be dismayed.
for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. There are 365 references in the Bible that say, fear not. Law enforcement, that's one for every single day for you. Take that with you. Fear not. And the reason you fear not, because I know, listen, you're going to face situations where you're afraid. I know you're tough, but you're not that tough. There's still fear. But know that God is with you. He will always be by your side. So fear not. And the last bullet is the bullet of servanthood. In Romans, it tells us, for he, that is the law, is God's servant for good. May you always remember that you are here to serve the good of all people in society, and that you do good things and you are appreciated. And today, I appreciate those who have gone before us, but I also appreciate those that are here now with us in the present. May you continue to carry on the legacy of being a sharpshooter with 6 bullets, just like the Lone Ranger, and may you continue to do what you do and keep us safe and know that there are people that are grateful for you. Thank you, and God bless you.
At this time, let us please observe a moment of silence. Whereas on Tuesday, May 8th, 2018, we, the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, together with the Department of Aging and Human Services and seniors and law enforcement together, SALT, Council, salute the members of law enforcement for their continuing dedication, and whereas throughout the United States, more than 900,000 men and women put on their uniforms, strap on their sidearms, and put their lives on the line to ensure the public's safety, and whereas nationally, a total of 1,511 law enforcement officers have died in the line of duty over the past 10 years. Currently, there are 21,541 names engraved on the walls of the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial. Since 1808, Maryland has lost 306 officers who have made the ultimate sacrifice. And whereas police officers are the front line in preserving our citizens' right to live in a crime-free environment that is all too often threatened by the insidious fear caused by violence in our community. Now, therefore, we, the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, do hereby declare Tuesday, May 8th, 2018, Law Enforcement Appreciation Day, in honor of federal, state, and local law enforcement officers killed or disabled in the line of duty, and call upon the citizens of St. Mary's County to observe this day with respect and gratitude. This date, May 8th, 2018.
Thank you. Be it known, because of your demonstration of high integrity and ability meriting our great trust and respect, we are most pleased to award you this governor's citation in appreciation to your outstanding services to the citizens of this state, and it's signed this day, May 8th, by Governor Larry Hogan, Lieutenant Governor Boyd Rutherford, and Secretary of State John Woven Smith.
And with the gratitude and appreciation for all that you do to keep the residents of St. Mary's County safe and to make a difference in the lives of others.
Our law enforcement agency put on the uniform each and every day, and to go out in our society without any mental reservation to pursue and to protect what we take for granted.
Senator Wall sends his regrets for not being able to be here today, but he asked me to thank all those being honored for your selfless dedication and service to St. Mary's County. We honor you.
The sacrifice and dedication shown to your community and department serves as an inspiration to all, especially the next generation to come. Presented on this 8th day of May 2018 by the St. Mary's County House Delegation, Delegate Jerry Clark, Delegate Matt Morgan, and myself, Delegate Deborah Ray.
On behalf of the Department of Aging and Human Services, the Triad SALT Council, and the older adults of St. Mary's County, I want to say what a privilege it is for me to be here to share this time that we have together, honoring this year's Officers of the Year, And I want to also say thank you for your time and dedication, your commitment to serving others, not just the seniors of the county, but for all citizens of the county. And thank you all for being here.
At this time, I invite Deputy First Class Blaine Gaskill to join us on the stage. From the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, officially commends Deputy Blaine Gaskill, St. Mary's County Sheriff's Office, for his dedication to the safety of students and staff of Great Mills High School. His quick thinking and ability to act without hesitation demonstrates his selfless commitment to others, rightfully earning him our sincere gratitude, respect, and admiration. We are honored to recognize his service and ask God's continued blessing upon him. This date, May 8, 2018, signed by the five commissioners of St. Mary's County. I'd like to have Director Landon is got a citation for you also from the governor's of Maryland.
Morning, Deputy. I'm here representing Governor Hogan again, but I'd also like to let you know why I'm so honored to be here also. I served for 30 years as a Maryland State Trooper, retiring as a Lieutenant Colonel, before I had the pleasure to work with Governor Hogan. So, this means a lot to me, and I knew what it meant on the rainy day in March when I came from Alexandria over, and I didn't have to argue with Governor Hogan. He told me he would be here as soon as he could get here, and he did come. And I'm going to read the letter verbatim that Governor Hogan has sent to you. Dear Deputy Gaskill, the First Lady and I would like to commend you for your demonstration of true courage and selflessness during the devastating school shooting at Great Mills High School. I cannot express enough how grateful we are for your quick thinking, bravery, and valor that went above and beyond the call of duty. Again, on behalf of the state of Maryland, I thank you for your heroism and offer you my very best wishes. And it's signed sincerely, Larry Hogan, Governor. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Deputy Gaskill, Sheriff Tim Cameron will now present you with a token of appreciation from the Commissioners of St. Mary's County and Department of Agency Services. Sheriff. In closing, I want to thank all for joining us on this special occasion. Please remember to thank those in law enforcement for the job they perform each and every day for the safety of our people, our community, and our great country.